flying low over the Amazon rainforest with agents from Brazil's Ibama Environmental Police. We zero in on the target, the turquoise waters of an illegal gold mine, carved into the heart of the jungle. First chopper down, now the hunt is on. We follow as Ibama agents search the camp, prepared for retaliation. They arrest the leader of the mine and seize weapons.
The first helicopter came down with a number of men armed. They came out, secured the area, make sure nobody else here had any weapons that they were pointing at the helicopter, something that has happened in the past. Now it seems to be fairly under control.
The man in charge shows us the precarious tent they all share. I know we're destroying the trees, he says, but unfortunately, it's the only way for those of us who live here and don't have jobs or studies. He says the gold they've mined is barely enough to survive on. But the excavator he bought is worth over $100,000. Ibama agents say it's big business, tearing up the rainforest, contaminating rivers for generations to come. We're fighting a war, he says, a war to protect the environment in Brazil. They destroy the camp, although the workers were set free. And we head back to the base to gear up for a night raid on illegal loggers, led by a 32-year-old known by her many enemies as the Blonde Devil. They're hauling out 19 trucks a day from indigenous territory, she says. They're stealing from the country, and it's our job to stop them. The first truck takes them by surprise. State agents shoot at the engine to stop it. Then the first arrest of the night. Agents now hunker down and wait.
We're waiting for a second logging truck, but in the meantime, we've heard on the radio that the order has been given to run over anybody who gets in their way.
But the next series of trucks are halted at the barricades without confrontation. More arrests follow.
The operation has just come to an end. They managed to get 5 trucks. If you can come along here with me, I know it's really hard to see because it's dark, but these are absolutely enormous logs. They've come from an indigenous territory about 15 kilometers away, and they go for thousands on the retail market.
Overwhelmed and underfunded, the eco-police then use one of the few effective tools they have. They torch it all, the illegal logs, trucks included, and take a few minutes to savor their small victory in a very long ecological war. Shasta Darlington, CNN, Novo Progresso, Brazil.